The reefs around Catal thrive with all manner of marine life. Almost every meter of a dive will reveal an organism that is perfectly adapted to that niche environment.
Oh.
When we learn to dive, we are naturally drawn to the larger inhabitants of the reef, the triggerfish, the stingrays, the morays, the sharks, but we tend to miss some of the largest animals that live there, the corals. The aim of the short film is to provide an insight into these fascinating organisms in the hope that the next time you dive, you might take a closer look at these amazing animals and thereby gain even more enjoyment from your diving. What is a coral? A coral is a colony of tiny marine animals called polyps. A coral head, although perceived to be a single organism, is actually comprised of thousands of genetically identical polyps. A polyp is a multicellular organism, the visible part of which consists of a ring of tentacles which, depending on its size, are able to sting and capture a range of prey such as nanoplankton and even small fish. Although able to catch and ingest prey, most corals derive only about 10 to 20% of their energy needs through this method. For the majority of their energy requirements, corals rely on a symbiotic relationship that they have with a class of algae known as zooxanthellite, and polyps of a particular coral would typically host a particular species of zooxanthellite. The zooxanthellite obtains its energies through photosynthesis using CO2 and nitrogen as waste produced by the polyp, and in return the polyp is able to absorb the excess energy produced by the algae. The algae provide the corals with their basic golden brown coloration, with other colors being achieved through the coral's absorption of the pigments and their exposure to light. Should the coral become stressed, for example through temperature change, the polyp will eject the zooxanthellite that it harbors and will subsequently lose its coloration and appear white, a process referred to as bleaching. Bleaching doesn't mean that the coral has died. Should the stress subside, then the coral might be able to regain its zooxanthellite and recover. If not, then it will eventually starve and die. On the reef, there are two main types of coral: hermatypic or reef-building corals, otherwise known as hard corals, and ahermatypic or non-reef-building corals, otherwise known as soft corals. The polyps of hard corals have six or multiples of six tentacles and are able to extract calcium ions from seawater and deposit them into a aragonite skeleton that is characteristic of its species. Soft coral polyps have eight tentacles and a skeleton formed of proteins with minute spiny or sand-like skeletal elements known as sclerites, which are formed of calcite. So even though they don't help directly in building the reef, the calcite that they contain is a benefit to the reef after they die. A coral will grow through the asexual reproduction of its individual polyps. New colonies can be formed by spawning, which normally occurs in mass around full moon, or by fragments being taken from the parent colony.
Seventh seal, silence covered the sky.
All corals have polyps, and some are easy to see during the day. Examples of this are Pleurotura, the bubble coral, Euphyllia and Cora, the anchor coral, and Sarcophyton, the leather coral. Although the bubble and the anchor corals appear to be soft corals with their polyps inflated, they are actually hard corals with a large calcium carbonate skeleton. During the night, their large polyps, which are filled with water during the day, begin to deflate to retreat back into the safety of their skeleton, leaving behind a barely recognizable zigzag of skeleton where the polyps used to be. The soft coral Sarcophyton, the leather coral, also undergoes a dramatic transformation as its long-stalked polyps, which dance and sway in the current during the day, retract completely inside the flesh of the coral, leaving a smooth, leathery surface. As some corals retract their polyps at night, so others reveal their hidden beauty. Corals that appear solid during the day begin to extend their polyps to feed. Space on a healthy coral reef is always at a premium, with different organisms vying for the limited space. Some achieve dominance by growing quickly and smothering their neighbors. Still others protect their space by having specialized tentacles called sweeper tentacles. When a sweeper tentacle encounters a competing coral, it may attack it and literally burn the offending coral to the point of either killing it or severely damaging it. Not to be outdone, soft corals generally compete with the hard corals by releasing terpenoid or Sarcophyton compounds into the water to injure or impede the growth of neighboring corals, and then outgrow these impeded individuals in a process called allelopathy. Thank you. This documentary aimed to highlight the amazing diversity of life on the reef. Corals not only provide the reef with its physical structure, but also provide the reef inhabitants with protection, food, and indirectly with oxygen. Without the corals, there would be no reef, and the abundance of marine life that is seen today would not be there. The next time you dive, take the time to take a closer look at the corals around you, and see the beauty that resides there.